Hello friends, welcome back. And I am Dr. Scientist Chadda over here. And you are seeing on FCHEC Excel Master. And today we have a special breaking news about XLOOKUP. And to tell you about more in detail XLOOKUP, I am going to invite my friend Faraz Sheikh, who is in our studio today. He will tell us in detail the new version of XLOOKUP. So over to you, Mr. Faraz. Kindly let us know what do you have new for XLOOKUP.
Thank you very much, Doctor. And my friends, let us look what is the new version of XLOOKUP looks like. But if you have seen my earlier video where in detail I have explained about XLOOKUP, so feel free to check that video as well. Now let us look at XLOOKUP. Now if you have seen that video, in that video we have saw that there were only 5 arguments which need to be passed and 2 were an optional, which was match mode and search mode. But now we have a 6th argument, which is if not found. This is really awesome stuff. So in case if in your data you don't found that information, then you can replace it with some text or you can just give a warning message. So let me quickly demonstrate and show it to you how it will work out. So we have the list of employees numbers and the other is the list of the employee with their department names. Now we would like to extract the employee name over here. So we are going to say equals to XLOOKUP. The lookup value will be employee ID, comma, and the employee ID over here. I'll be looking in this one, hit by F4, make that range as an absolute reference, comma, and my return will be also the employee names. And again, this is also as an absolute. Close parentheses, enter. In earlier XLOOKUP function, we were not having this if not found. So when we used to drag this formula down, we used to get this error NA. And we used to simply fix this problem by saying if error, and we can just pass any value just as a blank over here right now, and we are tracking it down. So we used to handle this kind of a problem by nesting it inside another function. Now with the new version of XLOOKUP, now we can simply give that argument over here on the 4th argument, and we are going to replace wherever the NAs are there, we are going to add an emoji. And to activate the emoji, just simply hit the window key and the greater than sign. So let's add the emoji in the quotes. And we got this emoji over here. And we are going to say, if you not found that guy, just be sad. Okay. And close this. And we are just going to say enter. Wonderful. Now let us drag it down. Boom. So we have these numbers which are not in the list. Now with the single construction of the formula, the things has become so easy. Now let us go and add some new data to our data set. But before that, we are going to convert the data into Excel table. Control T. Yes, my table has headers. The reason why I'm doing this, because I need my range to automatically get expand when I add the new data. Now as soon as I added the new data to my data set, you have seen that the range has automatically got expanded and we have this new names also got updated. Unfortunately, we still have this employee number missing, but it's a great way to identify if you have any missing numbers which are not found in the list. So that's the new version of XLOOKUP. As we still know that it is in Office Insider channel, so the Microsoft team is frequently making some changes to it so that it can be very handy to all of us before it is out. Well, this new version of not found argument is really awesome and I really enjoyed it. So let me know your thoughts about it and I would love to hear from you, my friends. And over to you, Dr. Scientist Chadda.
Oh, wow, that was a great insight about XLOOKUP. So stay tuned, my friend, and we will see you in the next video. It was really great to have you over here. Till then, take care. Bye.